Hi, it's Mike Chen. Now, I'm not a very pessimistic person, but this video is gonna be a little gloomy because there are places around the world where a lot of people live that are not the most stable. I mean, we already know that every morning we wake up, it just kind of brings us closer and closer to maybe some sort of catastrophic disaster that could spell doomsday for the entire human race. I mean, even though we don't think about it, while we're enjoying our cup of coffee, maybe a mega earthquake could shake things up right under our feet, or while we're eating our cereal, a super volcano is slowly waking up to spread Armageddon the moment we clock into the office. Because there are so many nightmare scenarios that have a high possibility of happening within the next 3 or 5 decades, and there's really nothing we can do to prevent it because nature really runs on its own schedule. So in this video, we're gonna count down 5 mega disasters that can potentially happen tomorrow. We'll start off with number 5, West Coast wildfires. The state of California is no stranger to wildfires. Every year, hundreds upon hundreds of acres are burned down by forest fires that seem to be getting worse over time. In fact, in a study made by the U.S. Geological Survey and Forest Service, they reported that the acreage burned by wildfires has skyrocketed to 6.4 million since 1999, drastically tripling from an annual 2.2 million acres. If this number keeps on going up, experts predict that a large portion of the country will be up in flames in the very near future. Also, according to the Harvard School of Engineering and Applied Sciences, or SCAS, wildfire season in the US will be twice as smoky and will last longer by 3 weeks, unforgivably burning and scorching massive portions of the West Coast every single year. Additionally, they point out that the increase in the Earth's temperature due to climate change has greatly contributed to the worsening situation of annual wildfires. To add more salt to the wound, campaigns to stop forest fires like Smokey the Bear have only exacerbated the problem because it prevents the natural cycle of bushfires that clears out the forest underbrush. And today, with predictions of 30,000 to 50,000 annual wildfires, the US might eventually end up experiencing its literal version of hell on earth. Number 4, the East Coast submerge. In 2012, Hurricane Sandy was considered by many experts as one of the most devastating freak storms to ever hit the country in over 700 years. But with the rising sea levels along the East Coast of the US, we may not even need a storm like Sandy or Katrina to see major cities get swallowed up by water. John Boone, Professor Emeritus of the Virginia Institute of Marine Science, outlined a study and claimed that a significant change in sea level has been occurring since 1987, spanning the coastlines of Key West, Florida to Newfoundland, Canada. What is concerning about the study is that it shows that sea levels are increasing at about 0.3 millimeters annually. Even more troubling is a study by the US Geological Survey, which claims that water levels in the East Coast of the country is rising 3 to 4 times faster than anywhere else in the globe, making plenty of the coastal areas in the Northeast at high risk because of property values. And I knew this when I was living there, but the sea levels in New York City alone is expected to rise by 31 inches in 2050, submerging 25% of the city, as well as rendering 97% of its power plants utterly useless. With about 800,000 people living in high-risk flood zones, former New York City Mayor Michael Bloomberg proposed to create a flood system in 2003 that cost about $20 billion in order to save the sinking city. Unfortunately, the project was never put into action and is now collecting dust in a dark corner somewhere. Number 3, the eruption of Mount Fuji. When Japan's entire landmass shifted during the Tohoku earthquake in 2011, it also stirred 20 of the country's 110 volcanoes awake after increased seismic activities in their areas were recorded. Even more unnerving is the fact that any one of these volcanoes may erupt any day, according to the Japan Meteorological Agency. Of course, no stranger to tremors, Japan has suffered a sufficient amount of damage from earthquakes over 1,000 years. However, when we're talking about dormant volcanoes waking up, the whole scenario has added much more fear into the mix. In recent studies, calculations show that Japan is always due for a major volcanic eruption every 38 years, and it seems that the country is way overdue for one. Out of the 110 volcanoes dotting the island country, 47 are recorded as active. And among the 47 active volcanoes is the famed Mount Fuji, standing at a magnificent height of over 12,000 feet. And that is one of the volcanoes that is most likely to erupt at any time after a report was published by a scientific team from France and Japan. The news caused great concern to Japanese citizens as Mount Fuji is located only 62 miles from Tokyo. Should the volcano decide to erupt, let's say tomorrow, it would mean that millions of people will have to be evacuated from the city as they will most likely be covered in ash. Number 2, the big one. The likelihood of at least a magnitude magnitude 8 earthquake hitting California in the next few decades was increased by the US Geological Survey. Called the big one by many Californians, it is the one earthquake that they say will reduce the entire state into rubble and the one that everyone in the entire country has been nervously waiting for. The US Geological Survey goes even further in their findings, saying that a magnitude 8 quake or larger has a 7% chance of hitting California in the next 30 years. And from their recent findings, the odds of a 6.5 to 7 magnitude quake ripping through the West Coast state has gone up to 30%. Most researchers think that the big one will most likely originate from the breaking of the San Andreas Fault. However, other theories suggest that the mega quake will be triggered by the lesser known Hayward Fault that sits in close proximity to San Francisco. Regardless of the origin, experts all agree on one thing. The earthquake will definitely devastate the entire state of California and the neighboring areas in the West Coast. Basing their claims through historical data-based projections, the earthquake will most likely cause severe damage to major infrastructure and start full-scale wildfires due to the amount of dry bush that is common in the state. And it's essentially a race against time, as the White House has recently granted $5 million to a team of experts coming from UC Berkeley, Caltech, and the University of Washington in order to develop an earthquake early warning system that hopefully will alert people, and get this, only a minute before a tremor hits. Finally, number one, the Caribbean tsunami. In 2001, two researchers from the University College of London and the University of California, Santa Cruz, hypothesized that the imminent eruption of the Cumbre Vieja volcano in the Canary Islands will create the largest and most destructive tsunami in recorded history. Published in a co-authored study, Dr. Simon Day from the University College of London and Dr. Stephen Ward from UC Santa Cruz claimed that during the volcano's last eruption, a large rupture appeared on its left side, which has made the geological structure quite unstable. If it does erupt, the rupture to its side will result in a catastrophic landslide that will create the tsunami that will basically wipe out all the islands in the Caribbean on a scale that can only be comparable to the mythical Atlantis. With gigantic waves that are predicted to travel at 800 miles per hour and grow at least 330 feet tall upon first impact with land, the tsunami is believed to hit as far as Florida within 9 hours of its creation. As the rippling continues to build waves, the monster tsunami is also projected to hit as far as England. Of course, Dr. Day and Dr. Ward paints everything as a worst case scenario, since it is theoretically impossible for an entire landmass to fall into the water in one event. They say more likely parcels of land and rock from the volcano will tumble into its nearby waters piecemeal, but nonetheless create destructive waves, if not the feared monster tsunami itself. So yeah, out of these five places, I lived in two, and I'm even thinking about moving to Japan. But you know what? Here's my take on the whole thing. If it's your time, it's your time. I mean, it doesn't take a massive disaster to kill somebody. Every year, people die from random things like coconuts falling on their heads. So yeah, I'm just gonna live my life. I mean, I'm not gonna go swimming with great white sharks or live with grizzly bears or anything, but I'm not gonna be so paranoid that I won't live in New York City or San Francisco, even though I know eventually something's gonna happen, because Manhattan is just an island with like 10 ways to get off it. And also it's 60 years overdue for a major hurricane. So maybe if you're gonna buy property in New York City, maybe just buy something, you know, higher up in a building. But let me know what you guys think, especially those of you who are living in one of these places that may face an ultimate catastrophic disaster. Are you worried? Are you scared? Do you not care? Do you think the way I do, in that if it's your time, it's your time? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you all so much for watching this video. See you later.